I'm Olivia.
I'm Maya.
And I'm Lucy.
And this is BBC School Report.
So, AI is taking the world by storm. It helps in your day-to-day life, it helps with immobility and can remove boring tasks. However, AI could come with many dangers. It only has one purpose that it's programmed, and that could be different to our initial expectations. And if AI is in control of a vehicle, that can lead to dangerous situations. It can also lead to job loss. For example, 34 jobs were lost at the start of this year, at the start of 2017, in Japan at a life insurance company.
An IT technician here at Sherburn High School says that he won't have it in his house because of private issues. It's always listening and could pick up bank details, addresses, and other private information. You don't know who can access your information, it just collects data.
So this is Miss Palmer, she teaches art at Sherman High School, and we're going to be interviewing her today. So do you own any AI, like an Alexa or Google Home?
I don't, but I have a lot of my friends that do, and they kind of talk about how great it is to have one, which has made me think maybe I should get one as well.
How do you think it could affect like your everyday life or just like the little things that you have to do?
I think the way it probably would help me is putting the kettle on and making a cup of tea, which sounds really small, but I do spend a lot of my time either asking other people to go make me tea or me getting from doing it. So I think it'd make life a lot easier, but then again, I think maybe it would make people maybe a little bit lazy.
Yeah.
And, you know, I don't know, I think things maybe don't have that touch of like a human touch, somebody doing it for you or somebody helping you or you going and making something yourself. I think you get a lot of satisfaction from just maybe doing little things and making little things, yeah.
Yeah. So what do you think about the number of jobs that have already been taken over by AI and how that could progress?
I think it's really sad, because it obviously means that a lot of people who are skilled and who are trained to do certain things, they're now out of a job and might have to retrain in a different area. But I think it's really sad for people who have lost their jobs.
So today we have Anne Hannum, the librarian at Sherburn High School. So, do you own any AI in your home?
I do. I have an Alexa and two Dots.
Does it scare you that it can pick up any private conversations?
I think if I was the type of person that had secrets or, you know, were plotting some kind of mischief, then maybe it would bother me. But if it wants to listen to mine and my husband's boring conversations, then let it get on with it.
So how do you feel knowing that 34 people lost their jobs due to AI in Japan?
Well, obviously any job losses are sad, but within any industry, when you have progress, you will have downsizing of staff. So are the losses directly due to the AI production, or has it been natural streamlining within a company, making the company more efficient? I'm sad that people have lost the jobs, but on the other hand, it happens throughout industry.
Okay, thank you. To summarise, AI is very helpful in the home, but it can come with more than you bargained for. Make sure to keep your private information private to avoid danger. Bye for now.
Bye.